show us your ways today. We're going to be led by the Spirit. Hallelujah. Show me your ways, that I may walk with you. Show me your ways, I put my trust in you.
Cry in my heart.
Sorandiki sita maha, obra tiki sandala botomen.
strength, Lord. Almighty God, Almighty God, the power in your name above every name. You are the creator and you created everything. Therefore, you are above all things, and your throne is above all things, and your power is above all things, and your might is above all things, and your ability and strength are above all things. And we come to you, Lord, to show us the way, because you are the one that bestows power and strength and ability and might and discernment and wisdom, Lord, and glory and power. It is of you, Lord. It is of you, Lord, and we look to no other place. We look to no other place for authority. We look to no other place for power. We look to no other place for wisdom. We look to no other place for might. We look to no other place for strength, Lord. We don't look around at what's going on in this world, because you are our authority. You are the kingdom authority, God, and we work and we move and we live in a higher realm, in a higher place, the place of the kingdom, where there is a ruler and there is a mighty ruler and there is a powerful ruler and there is an exalted ruler, a ruler that has been exalted above every other thing that ever was created or ever existed. How dare the heathen rage at you? How dare the heathen rail at you? You are laughing on your throne. You are laughing in your throne because you know how they work. You know how they think. That you know how they move, because you created them. But Lord, we are recreated to a higher realm. We are recreated to a higher place. We are recreated, and you lead us, and you guide us, and you empower us, and you infuse us with your wisdom, Lord. And Father, this day we humble ourselves under your mighty authority, Lord, and under your wisdom and under your power. Bring us up, Lord, to where we trust no other voice but the voice of our Lord and Savior. And we call you Mighty God, Mighty God, Mighty God, Mighty God, Mighty God. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! You reign, Lord! You reign! You reign! You reign! There is no other king. There is no other authority. You reign, Lord! And you reign supreme!
Praise. Let's just pray in the spirit a little more. Let's edify ourselves. Oh, hallelujah. call. Somebody in this area over here has been having chronic headaches. If that's you, come up quickly. Maybe more than one. Come up quickly. Chronic headaches. This side of the auditorium. Over here. Quick. Headaches. Come on. That's it. It's okay. We want to be delivered. Amen?
Amen.
Praise Him. Now, if you are on this side and you've been having chronic headaches, God's no respecter of person. You can jump in on that too. Amen? Don't you love how God is an all-inclusive God? Amen? But where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Amen? And so we're going to stretch out our hands real quickly. Thank you, Father. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Not yours to care about. Not yours to worry about. It's stress-related, and it's bound in the name of Jesus. Does that bear witness with your heart? Stress-related, it does? Yes. All righty. Lift up your hands. That's where your help is coming from. We bind you oppression right now. Oh. I want right now, because that means you're ready to get it. Amen. And let's stretch out our hands. The Spirit of the Lord is heavy up here.
Yes.
And ushers, get ready. Hallelujah. I don't even care what it is. God knows. Oh, yeah.
Thank you,
Father. We curse that pain.
Yes.
Oh, that affliction in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah. Yeah, and your mouth says, I'll never be the same again. Oh, I'll never be the same again. My body will never be the same again. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Never. Woo, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Come on up. Stretch out your hands. Oh, we thank you. Yeah. Woo. There it is. Oh, yeah. There for a time you were getting discouraged, says the Lord. But did I not say to you, take courage? You are a mighty man, and there is great things that I have for you to do, and you are doing them. And greater things shall you do, says the Lord. Nothing can limit you. You are my child, and you are an overcoming child of God. So use your mouth and pray. Use your heart and pray. Do the things that I have said to you. Be obedient in what I have asked you to do. And great, says the Lord, shall be the power of God in your life. And great shall be the fruit of your ministry, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah, the Lord says it's on you. Yep, that's it. Stronger. Woo, there. Whew. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes. Thank you, Father God. Maria de Moriani and Mokumi.
Continue to stretch on our hands, amen. Glory to God. Praise you, God. Glory to God. He's the healer. Thank you, God. Let's just pray in the Spirit. Oh, and maybe you don't know about how
Praise God. Where the Holy Spirit moves, there's Holy Ghost activity. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we stretch out our hands again? We're a part of this. Amen. God's church is the dream team. We're the hand of God. Amen. And when everywhere it says that God casted out devils by the finger of God, that was the Holy Spirit. But we're now his hands and his fingers. Amen. And he'll use us by the Holy Spirit. Praise God. Can we lift up our hands real quickly and thank the Lord again for what he's done? He's healed. He saves. He delivers. Amen. He's awesome in leading and guiding. Let's just give him a thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you thanksgiving. We glorify your name. Hallelujah. Thank you for healing these. Thank you for delivering. Thank you for straightening out the affliction and bringing health and healing and binding up their wounds. Hallelujah. Yes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Can we do, Lord, you are good. Yes. Lord, you are good. Glory to God. Say, Lord, you are good.
You are good and your mercy endures. Praise!
Thank you, Jesus. You're so good to me. Thank you, Jesus. You're so good to me. Thank you, Jesus.
Sports, don't we? We love our sports, and they can get crazy at football games and crazy at basketball games and color themselves from head to toe and stand out there when it's freezing cold. How much more can we praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Amen? Because He is your King. He is your Father. Glory to God. But you know what? You're already here. You might as well jump on in. When I first heard tongues, I went into a church. I was brought up a Baptist girl, and I first heard, praying in the Spirit. You know what? It didn't freak me out. I got curious. I'm like, what is that? I want more of that. That's some Holy Ghost stuff. I don't want to be the boring old me. I want what God has for me. And I'm telling you, I was so hungry for God that day after that service. I drove home and my friend was with me and her mom, who was filled with the Holy Ghost. I said, I want what they got. And she pulled over on the side of the road, laid hands on me. I got filled with the Holy Ghost in a little Toyota truck on the side of 98 North in Lakeland, Florida. And it doesn't matter where you are or what you're doing, God will fill you up to overflowing. Amen? Glory to God. He is good. We praise you. Pastor Sherry, have anything? Glory to God. Now let's love on one another. We've been praising Him. Now we've got the body of Christ to love on. Amen.
Get out there and knock on the door. restaurant that they go to, you know, if you have a restaurant or anything, and they'll give you a couple of meals, you know? I've done that. Perkins gave me a coupon last year, like, six breakfasts and a couple of dinners. I just walked in, had to see the manager. Oh, yeah, yeah, we have the people all the time. We're in the back of the head. Don't if you have a lot of everybody doing it. You know, if you only get one or two and everybody just gets one or two, you got 12, 15 gifts and prizes, you know, and maybe a half or a little more golfers. And golfers usually bring a person. So he was supposed to leave this morning, and I guess he called up. Did he have a good Thanksgiving? I guess he was over his business. Gina, yeah, she came up with a last minute song list, you know, kind of all thrown together. I haven't seen it since Steve, maybe it's not good. I don't know. She's not here. So I guess she's running with the ball. Yeah, she's here.
Coming up very, very soon. Word of Power Bible School is beginning again, our second semester of our second year. And guess what the class is going to be titled? Blood Covenant.
We're
going to be on Blood Covenant with Pastor Sherry. And anytime Pastor Sherry teaches, she never teaches the same stuff. It's always new stuff, Word of God, of course, but it's always up a different mountainside. So, put on your calendar. We'll be putting out posters and everything. Wednesday, December 2nd is the first day of class, okay, Word of Power students? December 2nd, Wednesday, 7:30 p.m. is Blood Covenant will be starting. December the 2nd, yes. And we'll keep announcing that and putting that up, amen? And I'm excited to hear about this class. Praise God. And I want to personally thank, and so do pastors, the ones that came yesterday for Christmas decorating. Isn't the church pretty? Amen. I want to personally thank Pastor Dwayne, my honey. He was the only man here, but he did a great job. I want to thank Cheryl, Jillian, Michaela. I want to thank my daughter, Alicia. She put up about three Christmas trees, and she worked really hard. I want to thank myself. I want to thank Gail Atkinson, my right-hand girl, and Mitzi, and your mom, Sandy. That's right. Practically the whole role here, Sandy. Last but not least, Sandy. Amen. And I truly, truly thank you, each one of you, because we couldn't have done it without you. And we love the church being decorated at Christmas time. Praise the Lord. What time is it now?
Seed time, harvest,
and overflow time. Pastor David, praise the Lord.
Good morning. Now, if you guys ever heard me talk on offering on Thursday nights, I talk about God and how He cares about every little thing you do. He wants to be in every part of your life. You were created for fellowship. That's He wants to hang out with you. He cares about every little thing you do. And here's just a couple of scriptures about what He thinks about you. The first one is in Psalms 103. This is a song too. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and forget not all thy benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all their diseases. All their diseases. You got something on you that doesn't belong to you. Your God can take it away from you. And then I like this other part. It says here, forgiveth all thy iniquities. You know, there were three people in the Bible that did great things for God. Well, two especially, not the third. Moses killed a man. Look at how mightily that man was used. God forgave him and used him mightily. Look at David, who killed a man, had a man killed, actually, and tried to hide it. Got right with God. Look at how mightily he was used. And then you got the thief on the cross at the very end. This is the thing I always had problems with when I first got saved. You did all this, you did all that, and then you're forgiven? You know, God's not like that. God can forgive the worst of the worst if you're forgiven, and He can use you mightily. Think of that thief. He's the first one in heaven with Jesus. I mean, that's amazing, you know? I'm sure there were people in heaven who would sit there and say, why is he here? You know, but heaven's not like that. Then Jeremiah, I like this one too. Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the thoughts I have towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and of not evil, to give you an expected end, a good end. He cares about a good ending. You have a good ending with Him. You know? And to get to the part about tithing. Of course, everybody always reads this about Malachi. Right? When you tithe. It's divine protection over your finances. Here's your chance to get your money blessed. I don't care if CDs are good, 401ks are good, but God's way can bless you more than you ever could imagine. You know, and here's how you get in on that. And I will rebuke the devourer. Who's the one that steals from you? Satan. Know who your enemy is. He's the one trying to make you sick. He's the one trying to take you home early. He's the one trying to take your finances. Well, he can't do that. You need to know who you are. He can't do those things to you. And you need to fight. It's a fight. There's no doubt about it. Because I can't use words for him, but you know what I mean, you know? To keep it clean. But he will rebuke the devourer for your sakes and shall not destroy the fruits of your ground. Your fruits will be blessed when you tithe. Neither shall your vines cast her fruit before the time of the field, saith the Lord of hosts. You know, it doesn't matter what kind of season it is. He can bless you any time of that season. So here's your chance, and I always say this on Thursday nights, we have a smaller crowd, but I double dog dare you to tithe. Let's see what God can do with your finances, you know? All right, has everybody got an envelope that needs one? All right. Let's pray. And please come on up when we do the offering so you can put them in the bucket, okay? Dear Heavenly Father, we just praise you for another opportunity to give back to you, Father. You've given us everything. You've made everything. You've done everything. Nothing's too hard or too great for you. And here's our chance to get in on our finances for that divine protection, like your word says. Your word is true. And we just thank you, Father, for blessing everyone who's here today, Lord. And give 160-fold, whatever, Father, that's according to our will, really, what we will and what we believe. And we just thank you, Father. We can receive the best and the most. Amen. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Can we get a thank you, Jesus?
Thank you, Jesus.
We want to call up our special psalmist today. We have Michaela and Jillian. Amen. And they're going to do a song special in honoring of the Lord. Amen. And we want to let the presence of the Lord fall today. Amen. And as they're getting prepared, I just wanted to say on our 20th anniversary party, that was one of the best days, I think, of my life, besides getting married and getting saved, obviously. And what a day that was. You know, everybody just blessed us and loved on us. And then, you know, I didn't think the day could get any better. And then I walk in the sanctuary, and here's these two beautiful women of God praising the Lord. And that was it. I was on the ground. I was crying. I'm like, God is so good.
Yes.
And I'm so proud of our youth. Our youth aflame are incredible people of God.
Yes.
And I'm glad I'm a part of them. Praise the Lord. And so can we just lift our hands before the Lord and let's just thank him for Jesus.
Thank you.
Aren't you glad?